Hi guys, I'm Tanya and I'm a travel blogger. Now that just basically means that I make travel videos and travel films and I post them on YouTube to serve as inspiration for you guys to be able to help you guys travel. Now I posted a video a few months back which was titled I Quit My Job to Travel. In case you've not watched that video, I'm going to link it up here on a card. But after I posted that video, a lot of you had a lot of questions around what I exactly do now and what's my job. Also, how do I finance my travels? So today I thought that I'm going to make a video to help answer all those questions for you and also basically take up all the questions that you may have had for me in the past few months. But before we jump into this video, I thought that I'd give you a little bit of an insight of what am I doing here sitting on a street in the night and shooting a video for you guys. So I'm in the city of Mumbai, the Indian city of Mumbai. Mumbai is the business capital of India and also has the second largest number of Art Deco buildings in the world after Miami. Can you believe that? I am sitting in front of one of the most iconic buildings of Mumbai. This is called the Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus. I'm only here in Mumbai for a day, which is why I did not think that I'd want to do a vlog about it because I'm only attending an event for Instagram. Instead of doing a vlog, I thought I'll still give you a little bit of a glimpse of Mumbai and shoot in front of an iconic building. So voila, here we are. Shooting in front of a building from Mumbai. Now getting into the questions that you guys have asked me. The first category of questions is mostly questions that asked me about me, which is quite strange because I realized after reading your questions that I've never really talked about myself on this channel. So the first question is from Aditi Bhati and she asks me, Hi Tanya, I have a few questions for you. Tell us about yourself, from where you are and what inspired you to bring about this change in your life and adopt traveling full time. So Aditi, to give you a little bit of an insight, I am from the Indian city of Delhi. I'm based out of Delhi right now because I live there with my parents, but I would say that I'm mostly an Indian because I've lived in all parts of India. My father had a government job while I was growing up and that facilitated me to study in 9 different schools across India in different parts of the country. So whenever somebody asks me where I'm from, I mostly end up saying that I'm from India instead of saying that I'm from a particular city. The second part of your question says, what inspired me to bring about this change in my life and adopt traveling full-time? To be quite honest, I was quite fond of traveling even while I was in college and I traveled quite frequently. After I got a job for myself and started earning, I decided that I'll take trips across India very frequently as much as possible because I had a passion for traveling. And along with doing that, I started posting pictures about my travels on Instagram. So I think that is where it was born from, the whole idea of sharing about my travels. While I kept sharing pictures on Instagram, I think people started following me and appreciating what I did. So from there, I realized that I wanted to also end up making videos about travels because just posting pictures about travel did not just cut it for me. I felt like I wanted to give everybody an insight into what I was exactly doing while traveling, how was I managing, how was I making bookings, and where was I staying. So I think videos are generally a very good medium of communication when it comes to sharing about something. So the next few questions from Manmohan Rai and Mayuri are also similar, asking me to answer something about myself. And Manmohan also says, how do you manage your expenses? So I think I'm going to come to that bit later. So a lot of you also asked me about my education and also what was my job before I started traveling. So I especially really like the question by Book of Pritesh, which asks me about your job and education, and also he's used this hashtag sit down video. I did my engineering, 4 years of engineering from Delhi College of Engineering in the branch of electrical engineering, and it's surprising how I'm not even using that degree right now, but it was quite a nice college. It's a government college in Delhi, which is how I spent most part of my educational years in Delhi in college, and I've grown quite fond of the city now. I got placed right after college and I had a job as a business analyst in an advertising company, an online advertising company, which is again not even associated with what I'm doing right now. But while I was working, I picked up a fascination towards travel and I started pursuing travel quite regularly because A, I could afford it, and B, I could take leaves or manage long weekends or something along the lines of that and keep traveling every month. So I used to set a goal for myself to be able to travel once at least every month to a different location, one that I hadn't been to before. So the second turning point was probably when I made my first YouTube video. I was traveling to Pondicherry at that point of time and I was still working and I had a job, and I took a few days off from my job to travel to Pondicherry solo. And while traveling, I realized, you know what, I want to make a video about my travels. I just took out my phone and I started vlogging along the way. It did not come very naturally at first, and making a video was super difficult because I did not even know how to edit. I did not even know how to shoot And I was shooting on my selfie camera the entire time. So it was not ideal, but I still wanted to make a video and just post it out there. I took a lot of time to edit that video, almost 3 weeks. But when that video was finally up, it received a lot of good response. People kind of connected to the story and they did enjoy the vlog. So that was probably the second turning point when I realized that I enjoyed making travel videos. So if any one of you is starting off with making videos, my first recommendation would be that you just have to enjoy the process of doing it. Don't have any secondary thoughts about making videos or getting onto YouTube. Don't do it for money. Don't do it for getting popular or getting famous, but just do it because you enjoy making videos. And that is what I exactly did. And I think that was the turning point when I realized that I want to do this full time. The next few questions, like from Sumit, Grishma, Kiran, Precious Bay and Garima Sasmal, are mostly about my timeline after I quit my job, like how I started off with YouTube, what I learned from traveling, how did I start out, how did I start out with travel vlogging, and also at what point of time did I decide that I wanted to quit my job and travel full time. So to cover a small brief timeline since I quit my job, before I quit my job, I actually made a very conscious decision about quitting it. And if you have watched my video, which is titled I Quit My Job, which I've already linked above, you'll realize that I actually planned my finances, saved up, bought a little bit of equipment that I could make videos with before I already had quit it. And after quitting my job, I read up very extensively about how YouTube videos can be monetized, how one can make money online, what are the various means of making money, or how can I just fund my travels, because travel is not inexpensive. It is definitely a very money intensive business, and if you want to be making traveling videos, you have to be able to travel to do that. So if you're wondering that YouTubers make a lot of money because there's ad revenue that comes into YouTube videos, trust me, that's so incorrect. Probably ad revenue has to be the lowest category of being able to earn online. And once I started off, I realized that quite quickly, that I'm not going to get a lot of money by just making videos and just posting them on YouTube. So I tried quite a lot of things and quite a lot of ways of making money online. I started off with a photography shoot for other people offline, which was not really an online business. So I did a few projects of that. Then after that, I picked up an online job as a social media manager for a few other brands, which is a freelancing gig, and that lasted for a few months. And I feel like taking photos and making videos is quite a useful skill to have, and you can actually make a lot of money by just doing that, by taking up projects. You can start small by taking up small assignments or doing it for somebody you know for a very economical fee, and then keep upgrading yourself from there. So even if you're not an influencer or not into social media, you can still start off by doing that, and you can travel even without a job if you can do that. The next question is from Avinash about how difficult was it to convince your parents to follow a YouTube career. Now, to be quite honest, I think before I quit my job, I had already made a few videos on YouTube. And while I did not have a lot of subscribers back then, I think my parents already kind of figured that I was really passionate about making videos and that I enjoyed doing it. And I was committed towards the whole process of making videos, because if you're starting off with a channel and you're not consistent and you're not committed to making videos, there's no way that channel is going to grow. So I think my parents have seen me through that whole phase of geeking it out and reading up about YouTube, to making videos by myself, spending hours and hours on learning how to edit videos. So because they saw me through the whole process of doing this, I think it wasn't very difficult to convince them eventually. And when I told them that I'm quitting my job, they were actually really supportive about it, and they seemed to have more conviction in what I was doing than me. So the next few questions are about solo traveling, so I've just clubbed them into a bunch of questions here. Like Akansha asks me about how I travel and manage in less populated areas. Do I ever feel helpless? Deepthi asks me, how's the experience of traveling alone and how do you manage with all the arrangements? Ruby asks me, how do you manage by yourself? And Simran asks me for tips for solo traveling. Also, we have a question by Harsha. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing that incorrectly. How are you super sportive and literally fearless? I have this huge dream of traveling solo. I think solo traveling is not really as difficult. It's just a state of mind mostly. As long as you can just take that first step of going on your first solo trip, because that first step is really difficult. So my advice to anybody who wants to travel solo would just be that go ahead and take that first trip. You'll realize so much about yourself, whether or not you like doing it, whether or not you prefer company, whether or not you want to be traveling solo again. And at the end of the day, you'll just end up learning a little more about your own self. For me personally, I think I don't feel bored of solo traveling at all, because I have so many cameras with me all the time and I enjoy the whole process of photography and videography. So I just keep at it when I'm traveling alone. And this camera has been a conversation starter for me on so many occasions, because people ask me, what am I shooting? What am I taking pictures of? And that has also helped me make a few friends along the way. And solo traveling never eventually ends up being solo, because you make friends on the way, you meet new people, and that's the whole point of traveling, when you absorb the culture of different places, meet new people, and when you get to experience the place from your own eyes without anybody else's perspective. So that's quite cool. But I'd specifically like to answer Akansha's question here about ever feeling helpless in a situation where I was alone. And to be quite honest, I think the answer to that would be no, because if you're traveling solo, try and follow the same things that you would follow back at home. So be cautious about your personal safety or about the safety of your luggage. Do the same things that you would probably do while traveling in a public transport back in your own parent city, or things that would protect you from any kind of harm coming your way. Like, don't wander into dark lanes and alleys by yourself, or don't ever get too drunk out of proportion, or don't ever talk to strangers who you think are fishy in your opinion. So I kind of feel like this video has already become really long, so I'll kind of shoot the second part of it later and answer more of your questions. But to take the last question for today, I think I found this question really interesting. It's from Azhar Somani asking me, how to be an influencer and take YouTube as a full-time career. So I feel like when I was growing up and watching YouTube videos, I mostly watched videos that helped me personally into becoming a better person. So I used to watch tutorials, instructional videos. I used to watch videos like how to swim or how to skateboard. And yes, those are two activities that I've actually learned from YouTube. So YouTube for me was a place full of resources and ideas where I could learn new things. So I think my number one tip to you guys would be, try to make videos that actually help other people instead of trying to become an influencer or a celebrity. So we have this whole culture of the idea of becoming a celebrity these days, because we see so many YouTubers who've made it big in their life because of making videos on YouTube. But honestly, I feel like everybody should start off with making videos that can help other people first, and then maybe trying to internalize the whole process of making videos. An influencer should be one person who can help other people and who can add value to other people's lives. So first, make videos that other people can connect with, and in no time you'll have people who would want to ask your advice in whatever domain you're making videos in. So guys, that was all for this video, and I hope this video helped you understand a little bit more about me and what am I doing out here, because I haven't shared as much about myself on this channel before. And if I haven't answered your question yet, I'll get to making a part 2 of this video. So make sure if you have any questions for me, you just put down under any comment under any video with the hashtag sit down video, and I'll get to eventually answering your question. Also, if I haven't answered your question for this video yet, I'll go back and personally answer them under the comments of the post that I posted in the community tab. And while you're at it, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button, share button, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And while you're subscribing, also hit the bell icon to stay notified with all future videos. I'll see you later. Bye bye.